Hi guys, my name is Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive Magazine, and today we're having a look at the Powercab 112 and Powercab 112 Plus from Line 6. Now these are essentially loudspeaker systems to be used with your modeler of choice, such as the Line 6 Helix, which is very popular right now, or the Fractal Axe Effects, or Kemper, you name it. They're compatible with any modeler that you can think of. And the whole idea behind them is, instead of being just an FR-FR system, they are capable of running that way, they are speaker modeling amplifiers. So essentially, they don't have any amp modeling components in them, but they will model the way that a speaker sounds in a room, which is interesting because most conventional IRs model a speaker through a mic, whereas this amp sets out to model just the physical sound of the speaker. So basically, it's a bit like standing next to the amp that you're trying to model, as it were. So it just kind of improves your playing experience a little bit. Now, we're going to talk about the spec in just a moment, but before we do, a little word on what you heard in the intro. You would have heard me playing all of the notes. Don't worry, there's some more tasteful and restrained stuff coming later on in this little demo. You would have heard me playing through a solo lead OD on a Line 6 Helix, which is essentially a Soldano SLO model. It is the default settings. We've left this as simple as we possibly can. We have an Elephant Man, which is a Memory Man model, type delay. And you were listening to, first of all, the AKG 414, which was on the front of the Powercab, so you can hear how it sounds in the room. You would have also heard the Powercab's DI output, and you would have heard a DI output from the Helix using the inbuilt IRs, if you can follow. And what I've done there is I've matched the IRs and the Helix as closely as I could to the model that we're using on the Powercab. And in that instance, it was a vintage 30. So on the Powercab, we have a camera set above the top. I'm going to show you this little fella over here. What we've got going on there is essentially, this is the Powercab Plus, as you can see, says someone there. We're essentially flicking through a bunch of different speaker models, and I was using this one, Vintage, which is based on a Celestian Vintage 30. And I was using an impulse response of a Cali V30 cab, which is a Mesa cab with V30s, on the Helix. And we were flicking between them so you can hear the differences between the bunch. Now, before we go any further, let's just try that one more time, but this time with a slightly more tasteful kind of sound. We're going to use a JTM 45 Bright on the Helix using greenbacks, and we'll use the same idea, so a greenback impulse on the Helix, and then we're sending the unimpulsed speaker to the Powercab using the green model, which I've selected up here on the back. And again, you're going to listen to the mic in the front, and then you'll listen to the DI out of the Powercab, and then you'll also listen to the IR out of the Helix, and you can hear how they all sound in comparison to each other. So I want to take a minute to talk about the differences between the 112 and the 112 Plus that we've been using so far. And it just so happens that I have a 112 in my hands over here, supplied by the good folks at Lane 6. They are essentially, from the front, very, very similar, with the exception of this little plus logo on the Powercab Plus, so that you know which one's which. But they do contain all of the same stock speaker models, which gives you a flat mode, a vintage 30, a greenback, a creamback, a Jennison, which is kind of great for Fender amps, we'll explore that in a moment, an Eminence Swamp Thang, and we also have an Alnico Blue, which is really good for Vox style models. The real differences between the two, essentially, they're both as loud as each other, they both share the same driver and the same power amp, and they're both compatible with any modeler that you can kind of dream of. The difference is with this one, the Powercab Plus, it allows you to host your own impulse responses and play those through the speaker, and it's also got MIDI connectivity, so you could actually set up different models on the Powercab to match up with your different patches on your modeler, such as your Helix. So let's say, for example, you had a lead sound and you wanted to use the Swamp Thang, you could do that on here, and then with a touch of a button, you could switch to, say, an AC30 type sound with the Alnico Blue kind of model if you wanted to on there. Speaking of which, just so happens we've recorded a demo using an AC30 model and using the Alnico Blue speaker model on the Powercab, and we're also using an Alnico Blue speaker model on our Helix. We're going to switch to a P90 guitar now just to hear how it sounds, and we're going to explore the AC30 model, Alnico Blue, Alnico Blue, the same setup as before. You'll hear a mic, you'll hear the DI from the Powercab, and you'll hear the DI from the Helix. Let's see how that sounds now. Taking a look at the back panel of the Powercab 112, what you can see is we have a pretty simple affair. There's a single button to switch between the flat mode and the various cab models. We have a large, very positive feeling volume control, a single input, which is a combi XLR and jack, and a single XLR output, which is going to give you the ability to connect that to a PA system, for example. We also have a ground lift, so if you're getting ground buzzes, either from connecting this to your modeler and connecting the modeler to the PA, or by connecting the modeler straight to this and then connecting this to the PA, whatever. If you're getting a ground hum, that's going to go some way towards fixing it. And finally, we have a really handy 80 hertz roll-off filter, which is going to take away some of that extreme low end that you don't really want in a live setting. Now, it's nice that you have the option on this one, because if you're playing on your own, sometimes it's nice to have that kind of extra grumble. But as soon as you get to rehearsal or you get on stage, you're probably going to want to engage that so that you can scoop out some of those really, really deep frequencies that will only serve to interfere with your bass player and your drummer. And we also have the same thing on the back here, but we're going to take a look at that back panel in more depth just in a second. But before we do, I wanted to explore one more amp type and one more speaker type as a comparison between the Helix's IRs and the Powercab. And this is going to be a Fender type amp. We are using the Deluxe model, using a Jennison speaker IR on the Helix, and we're using the Jennison model, which is called Jarvis, using the Jennison model on the Powercab. Once again, you'll hear the mic, you will hear the Powercab's DI output, and you will hear the Helix DI. We'll switch between those, and you'll get to hear how it sounds. Thank you. Right, so now we're taking a look at the back panel of the Powercab 112 Plus, which you'll notice is a little more fully featured than its cousin. So what we've got going on here is the usual kind of component. We have, once again, the low cut, as previously mentioned, very useful, ground lift. We have two inputs as opposed to the one. They're both nice, positive feeling combi jacks. Single DI output, which again, connected to the ground lift. We have MIDI in and through, which you would use to connect to your modeler so that you can kind of switch presets on here. Again, as previously mentioned, you can control that from the modeler so that the speaker on here changes with your patches, which is super cool. And we also have these digital in and outs. If you have a Helix, that's what the big red XLR out is for, just in case you're wondering. You can connect that up there and achieve similar results. And of course, we have, as previously mentioned, these very cool kickback legs, which you can use to angle the amplifier back to your head, which is quite nice if you need to hear it a little more clearly or you just don't want to destroy the audience in the front row. Very considerate of you. So I'm going to pop that back down. Let's flip that around and we're going to talk a little bit more about how it sounds. So the next thing I want to have a little bit of a look at is the different included speaker models that you get in the Powercab. Now, as previously mentioned, they will sound exactly the same in the Powercab and the Powercab Plus, but we just happen to have the Plus rigged up, so we're going to do it on this one. What I'm going to do is go back to the Soldano sound from the intro, and I'm just going to play you a couple of chords, and I'm going to scroll through the various included speaker models. I won't do flat just yet, though, because it'll sound disastrous because there are no impulses feeding it. But first of all, let's have a listen to the vintage model. It's going to sound like this. And now let's switch across to the Greenback model, which is over here. Move over to our next one, what we've got over here, we've got the Creamback, which should be a little crispier on the top end and a little more full frequency than the previous two. Let's hear how it sounds. Really like the sound of that one. I think that sounds great, but let's keep moving. We have Jennison next. Now, this is probably not appropriate for the Soldano type sound. It's more of a Fender thing, but we'll hear how it sounds all the same. It might actually be quite cool. Expect a lot of brightness on this one. I actually think that sounds pretty all right. It seems to complement it very well. You'll certainly be heard with that speaker, but let's keep moving. We have the Bayou next, which is based on an Eminence Swamp Thang, really dark speaker with a massive magnet and a silky high end and loads of lows. Let's see how that sounds. It's really nice, dark and creamy, that one. It's gonna sound great in an excessively bright room or if you like a really bright amp model. Let's move on though. Next one is going to be the Essex, which is an Alnico Blue. Again, expect massive projection and brightness with this one, but it should actually sound pretty cool. Here we go. So you can hear there's lots of top-end clarity and character on that one, and it really does capture the feel of that Alnico speaker kind of thing, which is really rather nice. So they're the included speaker models, but as previously mentioned, you can load your own IRs into this one. You can't do that with the normal Powercab, but with the Plus you can. It comes stock with a whole bunch of them as well, and they sound pretty wicked too. But it just gives you more customization options. But even with just those stock six, I think they sound fantastic. And if you wanted to use the IRs in your modeler and just use the power stage of the Powercab as an FR-FR response loudspeaker system, you can do that too. There's a flat mode, which is really quite nice. You can engage that. We will be looking at that a bit later, but before we do, I kind of want to get away from the sound thing for a moment because we've established it sounds pretty good, and I want to talk about the feel aspects of this. Now, one of the big complaints that I get from my fellow players who happen to use modelers is that sometimes it can be a little difficult to get your guitar to feel the same way that it does when you're playing on stage with a loud amp. And that's because a loud amp on stage is going to physically interact with your guitar. It's going to cause the guitar to vibrate because of the sheer volume that it's putting out. And in turn, the notes that you're playing will cause the guitar and the string to ring in sympathy with the amplifier, which creates a feedback loop. And it's not just feedback in the sense of ooh, like kind of big screaming, howling, high-pitched noises. It just makes the guitar sustain and sing in a really pleasing way. There's a reason why we like to play loud. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to play some similar lines on a comparatively low-gain setup. We're going to go back to that JTM-45, and we are going to compare, first of all, the way my guitar sustains when played just through the Helix through our studio monitors, and you'll hear the DI for that one. And then we're going to compare how it sounds to the Powercab. But what I want you to listen to is not so much the tone, but I want you to listen to the sustain of the guitar and how long those notes ring, bearing in mind that I'm not going to change a thing on the Helix. The only thing we're going to change is whether it's being played through the studio monitors or whether it's being played through the Powercab. Let's just compare that right now. So as you can hear, having the power cab next to me has made my guitar feel and sustain so much nicer than just having the Helix through the monitors. The Helix sounds great, don't get me wrong, and it does feel like it's responding convincingly in terms of the dynamics, but it doesn't have that physical interaction with the instrument that I get when I have the power cab next to me. So that's essentially the feel thing dealt with and the sustain thing dealt with. We've looked at the sound of the power cab. The last thing I want to do is I want to compare how it sounds on stage with a monitor versus the power cab. And for this, what I'm gonna do is we're gonna set up the AKG 414 in something approximating a player's position. And I'm gonna play a couple of examples using the same settings as before, but this time I'm going to switch the power cab out for one of our stage monitors here. So you can hear the difference with the mic in the same position, and you can hear how it sounds playing that same sound either through the DI or through the power cab. And to keep it fair, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the power cab's DI to power the studio monitors. So we're not using a different IR. It is literally the difference between monitor versus power cab. And let's hear how that sounds right now. Yeah. Now, I hope this comes across as clearly in the recorded audio as it does in the room, but having the Powercab next to me versus having the monitor, the Powercab is so much more pleasant to listen to as a guitar player, and it's so much closer to the experience that I'm used to from playing amps on stage. And it lets me kind of leverage all the versatility of my modeler, but still have that kind of amp on stage with you experience, which I'm guessing was why they designed this thing in the first place. Other things to bear in mind very, very quickly is it does have a really cool pair of kickback legs, which you can use to angle the amp back to yourself. If it's a bit like you'd see on old Fenders. It's a really cool feature. It's also immensely light. You can definitely carry it around with one hand. It's immensely loud. I think it goes up to, what it says on there, it's 125 dB sound pressure level SPL, which is monstrously loud. Like, don't turn it up that loud, you will hurt your ears, but it's good to know, it's a cool thing. And of course, because they are so light, you could think about taking a pair of them and running in stereo if you so desire, which is pretty cool. And you can even set up different speakers on there, which would be really nice. That's perhaps another experiment for another day though. I'm gonna leave that there for the time being. My name's Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive Magazine. Big fan of this thing, and I will see you next time.